Hi there.
In this video, we're going to learn about the color theme tool in InDesign, so let's get started. I have this image opened here, and let me type in something. So normally, I'd use a black color for my font here, or use one of the colors from the color palette on top, be it the regular colors that are on display, or use a color from the color picker. But then the colors I pick wouldn't really communicate well with my image here. And that's where the color theme tool comes into the picture. It sits with the eyedropper tool, so if you keep it pressed for a second, you'll find the drop down from where you can pick the color theme tool. The moment you pick it, you'll find a pop-up menu with colors matching your image. When you click the small arrow here, it will throw more options for you. So basically, it's a set of five colors, and InDesign has brilliantly divided the colors into these categories. And all these colors are sampled from our image, making it easy for us to pick and match colors to a text or shape or whatever elements we top it with. To apply any of the colors, all you need to do is click the color to pick it, and then click the element you want to copy this color to, and job's done. You can even add the colors to your swatches in case you need it for future use. Let me drag my swatches panel out. Now you see, at this point, I only have the default colors showing on my swatches panel. So let's say I want to add the colorful set to be added to my swatches. All I need to do is click this button that says add this theme to swatches, and instantly the colors will be added to my swatches. It doesn't end there. There is another button at the extreme right of the color theme tool, which is used to add the theme to your CC libraries in case you're using the Adobe suite. So click it and then go to your library and click the color themes and you shall find the themes sitting there. So it's an excellent way to create colors that complement an image you are using in a document. Older versions of InDesign might not have this feature, so if you don't find it in your InDesign, it's time for you to upgrade your version to benefit from this amazing feature. Alright guys, that concludes our session and it was a short one, so I'm going to see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.